Welcome to Engineers Academy. Subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon to receive the notification for the upcoming videos.
Okay, so let's solve this problem 26. So it's from 7th edition. So in this control rod AP exerts a force on this pin, right? So the control rod AP exerts a force F on the sector is shown. This is the sector. So this control rod applies a force. So we need to determine the X and Y and N and T components of the force. Right, so first we will solve for x and y components. So let me draw the free body diagram. So let's suppose if this is the x and y axis, right? So if this is, let's suppose, positive x axis and this is positive y axis, and this is the given force F. Let's suppose this is that given force, right? So let me write F here. So then we need to find the angle is given with the y axis, right? So here we are given that this angle is beta, right? So this angle is beta. So now we can directly resolve this force into its component. So then F of x will be, if I draw the components, so then this will be the F of y component in the negative y direction, and this one will be the F of x component, right? So in the negative x direction. So now if I solve this, so this is F of x and this is F of y, right? So F of y, so the angle is made with F of y, so it will be F cos of beta with negative sign, right? And similarly F of x, so it will be minus F sin of beta, right? So these are the x and y components of this given force. Now we need to find the n and t components as well. So let me draw the n and t axes as well. So let's suppose if this is the n axis, right? And let's suppose this is the y axis, t axis, let's suppose. So this is the positive n direction and this is the positive t direction, right? So now if I extend the negative y axis as well, so this will be the negative y axis, right? Let me draw it in red. This is the negative y direction, right? So now we know, we are given that this normal, the angle between the normal axis and the x-axis is alpha, right? So now I can write that if this is the normal, negative normal, so then this angle is alpha, this is given, right? So now as we can see that this n and t axis is rotated angle alpha from x-axis, right? So this means that the angle between this negative y and this t axis will also be alpha, right? Because this is also 90 degrees. And this is also 90 degrees, right? So if we place this n axis above this positive x axis and then we rotate, so then this angle of rotation and this angle of rotation will be same, right? So if this is alpha, so this is also alpha, right? So this means that if this is alpha, so then this is also alpha. So this means that this force F is making alpha plus beta angle with the t axis, right? So now if I draw the components, so if I draw the components of this force, so then this will be the F of t component, right? And then this one will be the F of n component. Let me draw it here. So this one will be the F n component, right? So now if I write, so this one is F of t and this one is F of n, and we can see both are in the positive direction. This is the positive and this is positive t, right? So the angle, the total angle is made with F of t. So this is alpha plus beta, right? So then N and T components. So then F of t. So F of t is what? F of t is F cos of alpha plus beta, right? And Fn is equal to F sine of alpha plus beta, right? So this is the solution of this problem. These are the two components, Ft and Fn. Now we are going to solve this problem 210. So it is also from the 7th edition, right? So in this problem, it is said that determine the N and T components of the force F, which is exerted by the rod AB on the crank OA. So we have this crank OA and this rod AB applies force on this crank. And evaluate your general expression for F is equal to 100 Newton and theta and beta are given, right? So this is given, this theta is given and this beta is given, right? So let me draw the free body diagram first. So if these are the x and y axis, right? And then let me draw the n and t axis as well. So the green one is n and t axis and the purple one are the x and y axis. This is positive y and this is positive x. This is positive n direction and this is positive t direction, right? And the force F is making angle beta with the y axis, right? So let me draw that force. So if this is that force, this is this force making beta angle. So now if I write this angle is beta, right? And now if I extend this, let's suppose if I extend this also, and here it is given that the angle between these two, the angle between x-axis and the normal axis, this is given, this is theta, right? So this theta is given. The angle between positive x-axis and the normal is given, that is theta. So now, as we see that if I extend this y-axis, if I extend this, so we can see, if I extend this y-axis, so it is making 90 degree with this positive x-axis, right? And as we can see that this t-axis, this is also making 90 degree with this line, right? So with this OA line, so this is that OA line. Let's suppose if I write this is O and this is A, right? So the tangent axis is making 90 degrees with the OA line. And here we can see that this y-axis or this line, vertical line, makes an angle, 90 degree angle with this positive x-axis. So this means that this line and this line both are perpendicular, right? So this means that if this is theta, right? So this is also theta, right? So this whole angle is theta. So I can write that this is theta, right? So this is the theorem. So if we have an angle between two lines, if we have this angle, right? So if we draw two perpendiculars at a particular point, let's suppose at this point. So let's suppose if I draw one perpendicular to this line and then I draw another perpendicular to this line, right? So the angle is transferred here as well. So if there is, if the angle between these two lines is known, so then the angle between these two perpendicular will also be this theta, right? So the same principle is applied here as well, right? So this is theta. So this means that how much this angle is? This angle is theta minus beta. So I can write it like this. So this angle is theta minus beta, right? So the force F is making theta minus beta angle with T, right? So now if you want to draw the components, so let's suppose if I draw the components, so then this one will be the F of T component, right? This one will be the F of T component, and this one will be the F of N component, right? So this one. And both are in positive direction, right? So this is F of T and this is F of N, right? So the angle is made with the F of T component, right? So we can write that F of T is equal to F cos of theta minus beta and it's positive, right? And we can say that F of N is F sine of theta minus beta, right? So this is the in the positive direction as well. Now here we are given that the F is 100 and theta is 30 and beta is 10. So we can find the answer now. So for A, if F is 100 newtons and theta is 30 degrees and beta is 10 degrees, so we can find the answer. So F of T will be equal to 100 cos of theta minus beta. So 30 minus 10 degrees, right? So we will get the answer for this and F of N will be 100 sine 30 minus 10, right? So let me solve this.
So now when we solve this, so this f of t component comes out to be 93.96, which is approximately 94 newtons. And similarly, the f of n components is 34.2 newton, right? So these are the f and t components for part A. For part B, solve yourself.